Today's tutorial is using Addiction Palette 6. It is romantic, it is sexy, it is versatile, and it is amazing. I love being able to utilize this for my brows. It's got two different brown colors in it, a cooler dark brown and a warm medium lightish brown. And I like to use the two of them together to create really, really dimensional brows and just kind of fill in over top of my microblading. And these brows kind of gave me trouble today. Well, at least this brow gave me some trouble today. But normally, it's a lot easier. So I just kind of get that basic shape. And then as we move to the front of the brow, I try to spoolie it out so it's nice and ombre. And then I take my light colored concealer. This is Marquisette in the Skin Nourishing Concealer. And using the other side of the Brow Artist brush, I etch out around it and then kind of fill over top of the lid as a little bit of a base for our look, and then take the blending bud and just kind of work it in, make sure everything is nice and even and soft. And then I also go into the center of the brows just to kind of clean up on that front end. And then if you need to, you can cut up and over the top just to make sure that everything is perfectly chiseled and perfection. Just make sure to blend in all of the concealer as you go. Putting a little bit of eye primer on first and blending it in with my blending bud, we are preparing for this gorgeous, gorgeous look. I am starting with this cranberry color, and I did not set the eye primer with anything or the concealer. So we are using this eye primer to its max ability and packing on that gorgeous color using the deluxe brush. So I'm just kind of doing tapping motions to really pack on that color to get a huge color payout. It may look scary at first, but it is worth it. And then taking a smaller, fluffier brush, I'm just kind of blending up and out, almost like creating a little bit of like a wingy wisp on the edge, just to kind of blend everything. And using the outside of the brow as a guideline as far as like where to go, how far out. And then taking a brush that has absolutely no product on it, just windshield wipering back and forth, that side to side motion, some little circles just to blend and create a little bit of a seamless flow on that craziness that we started with. It started scary, but it's worth it. It's worth it when you blend it. Tools are important. And then taking a little bit of that medium brown, I am just kind of taking another fluffy brush and just working it right up at the top where we blended that out, and just kind of adding a little extra pop of dimension to the look. So just back and forth, little circle motions till you get it where you want it. And then if you need to kind of go back and forth a little bit more and toggle back and forth between the two colors, you can do that as well. And then I'm just adding a little bit more of that cranberry just to make sure we don't lose any of that dimension as we are blending it out. And then taking this light pink color, I'm just putting it right up under the brow, not only to kind of blend the two colors together, but the contrast of that light color next to the brow is perfection. And then taking a little bit of my concealer right there on the lid and tapping it in with my finger, I'm going to use that as a base for these shimmer metallics. And I couldn't decide between the two, so I used them both. One's a pink berry color and one is like a champagne-y gold. So I used a little bit of both and just kind of tapped them on with my cream shadow brush. Just a patting motion, not side to side. And then taking that smaller crease brush, the fluffy one, with a little bit of that berry color, I am putting more pigment on the outer corner and the inner corner, and then haloing it right over top, just so it blends seamlessly, but also has that pop. And then taking whatever colors we used up top, we're also using them on the bottom. So that berry, that brown, we're smoking out underneath to make sure that everything is in unison and kind of seamless together. And then taking some black liner right along the lower lash line and then up and under the lashes to tight line on the top. I'm not bringing it all the way in on the bottom just because my eyes naturally are pretty small. And then just making sure to seamlessly blend everything. And